New developments in the case of the 12-year-old who was shot and killed after allegedly stealing a man's car in Denver.
Yeah, the problem solver is getting police records outlining the action that vehicle's owner took to track down the thieves, leading to a gunfight. Fox 31's problem solver Alex Rose is here on it. Alex.
Yeah, Jeremy, the car's owner has not been charged with a crime, so we're not going to be naming him. But a police affidavit gives us more insight on how he went about tracking down his car. According to the affidavit, the man became agitated with the police response during his call with dispatchers and continued to update the location of his stolen vehicle using GPS. The car's owner even made threats to protect his property with a weapon, according to police. Now, about an hour later, the man calls the police again, saying, "You guys would not stop it earlier, so he was going to stop it right now." He told dispatchers he was about to intercept the thieves. He indicated the car was right in front of him, and then dispatchers heard several gunshots in the background. The man said, "He shot at me and I returned fire." Again, the DA declined to charge the car owner in this case. So 12-year-old Elias Armstrong was killed in that shooting. The problem solvers have talked to his family in the past. They tell us two teens were with Elias that night, and they've refused to talk to investigators. The police records say they have video showing two people leaving the area where the shootout happened and getting picked up a few blocks away. Alex Rose, Fox 31. All right.